the special public works meeting for July 13th to order with roll call.
Mr. Katura?
Here.
Mr. McGill?
Here.
Mr. Paluna?
Here. Item number one is Russell Drive, discussion of paving options. We're going to hold that for a moment because we're expecting a couple more residents to be here. In the interim, we will have Mr. Bush give us an update on the annual programs, and he sent us an email. So, John, the floor is yours.
Thank you, committee. Earlier this week, we had put the final touches on our asphalt annual, and I had reached out to the committee via email kind of memorialize this, or to start from the beginning. Last fall, when we budgeted for the 2017 infrastructure budget, we had budgeted approximately $1 million for asphalt annual, for the asphalt annual program. Since then, and as we've been finalizing our project areas, as a result of the winter we had, there's a few other streets that have kind of come up as far as needing some attention prior to this upcoming winter. So with that, and as I had mentioned in my email, I'm looking at an estimate with all of the alternates, assuming that we would award them all, of just short of $1.6 million, which would be a $600,000 increase, based on my estimate, obviously, from what we had budgeted. I also discussed this with the finance director, and he was obviously, we all know the infrastructure fund should have enough funds to account for this, although it wasn't budgeted for 2017. He was going to address this to the finance committee Monday night, this upcoming Monday night, prior to council, and request the necessary budget amendment. Assuming that the committee would want to move forward with the full estimate, that we would have that ability come the next time we'd entertain the bids.
Does this pull forward some stuff from next year into this year?
Not necessarily. I guess in age maybe it would. Mm-hmm. You know, some streets that maybe would have, depending on how they would have fared from last winter, may have lasted one more year. So yes, I guess in essence it would, yes.
But don't count on it.
Don't, yeah. Every winter is different, so yeah, it's hard to say. Northeast Ohio.
Okay. Well, that's a pretty big shift, though, in dollars. I mean, that's a lot.
It is. It's some long streets that we're looking at. Some of the big streets that we're looking at Solon Boulevard. Mm. And Solon Boulevard's, as everyone knows, is a pretty big street. A lot of it's pretty much three lanes wide, pretty lengthy, all the way up from Aurora Road down to Arthur. Dorset Lane in the Thornberry subdivision, mm-hmm. from Bainbridge all the way to Winston. Some other work on Glen Allen on the southern end, and including a lot of curb work that over time the joints of a lot of the curb have deteriorated as a result, primarily probably from salt damage, primarily, I'm guessing. And then some other work, finishing up some work at Grantwood that we had started last year, as well as at the service department. They have a small area that we need to patch and repair a loop that controls the garage door for the building, or for the trucks to come in and out. Plus we have some general miscellaneous items that we always have.
Okay.
And it sounds like it is a big amendment to the budget, so we'll see what the finance department, finance committee says on that. But is there going to be enough money in the infrastructure fund to pay for this?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure.
Yeah. It's not that the infrastructure fund doesn't have enough money. It's about amending the budget, yeah. And doing the correct steps to make the increase to the appropriation.
Yeah, it's a big enough number that you have to amend the budget. I get that.
Do we also have to then amend, we'll also have to amend our chart that we use every month?
We'll do that on once everything's taken care of. Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
Thanks for the
next item. I know we're still waiting for a couple of people, but we'll start just because we do have some residents here tonight. This is item number one, Russell Drive, discussion of paving options. What I'm going to do right now is that's what I'm going to do. I will let the two residents who are here collectively, together, separately, whoever wants to speak first. If you want to both come up, you can both come up.
Hi, guys.
They're married, so I'll be interested to see who speaks first and last.
Usually lets me speak first and last, yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for your time. I'm Jennifer Pinnell, resident at Solent, 7527 Som Center. Just several points I wanted to make to the committee since the last meeting. In addition to hearing the results of Mr. Bush in his assessment, just some points I wanted to make. Prior to the recent work that was done on our street, the street was asphalt past my driveway and past my neighbor Joe Walagora's driveway. And now it's no longer that way. So respectfully, I would request at a minimum, that the street in front of my house and Mr. Walagora's house would be returned back to asphalt as it was before the resurfacing. And I do have images of different things in the street if you want me to share that.
Sure, if you'd like to show them.
Put them by that, just on top of that yellow square.
Like this?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And leave them there, and all our crack video team will.
And your home is the home on the right, correct?
This is my home, and this is Mr. Walagora's home.
Okay.
So this is a Google Earth image of, I think, around last year. I can tell by Joe's construction on his garage. But this is what the street looked like prior to the resurfacing. And this is prior to the asphalt being laid last year, so you can tell by the condition of the road it was in bad shape. I don't have a picture. Google hasn't taken a picture since when we had the nice asphalt, but that's what it looks like prior to the chip and seal. So today, these are images of what the street looks like. So you can see the chip and seal now that goes well past my driveway and Mr. Walagora's driveway, where it didn't before. Again, another image just showing what that looks like. Just a side note. Chunks of tar in my yard, soft tar, you can't remove without digging it out. That was left by the contractor. Just wanted to make that point.
And how far off of the road is this?
I mean, it's not far off, but it's...
No, but it shouldn't be there. I agree, yeah, but I'm just asking.
You can see the road right here, so it's okay. Not far off. It's just, that's probably, you know, the length of my foot.
Okay.
So. This is, you take an image of what the road surface looks like. This is what our road surface looks like. That's what we drive on. That's what we walk on. That's the stone that gets brought into my home when we walk through stone that comes through our driveway. So there's loose stone, tar, still after the sweeping.
So they did do the sweeping already?
They did do the sweeping. So I will make the point that they did do the sweeping. I think that we got a notice that they were going to. I was at work. I don't know that they actually completed it, didn't witness it, but we did have several days' notice, which is more than we had received for when they actually did the first laying of the chip and seal. But there's still loose stone. I mean, I can brush my hand and knock stone around. So in this image, it shows several streets off Aurora Road. They have similar zoning to Russell. But they have asphalt streets, no sidewalks, and curbs. Now, granted, they might have city water, which some of the residents on Russell do not, but they're still zoned the same way, so I'm not understanding why we don't have a street surface similar to these roads. Some of these roads are Arlington Boulevard, Elmwood Road, and Highland Drive. Just some images of those streets, what they look like, but it would be really nice if our road looked like. Again, these are dead-end roads, like Russell, no sidewalks. And I just included in the packet a larger image of the zoning map if it was easier to read. So the purpose of us being here tonight is just, we weren't so sure what the proposal was going to be, but just again to voice our concerns and again, respectfully request that the city return the surface of our street back to the way it was last summer with the asphalt. Thanks.
Thank you very much. I had the opportunity to drive down your street about a week after the last meeting we had, and Mr. McGill asked for this meeting, and I wanted to make sure that I drive down it. And I do see what you're saying with the condition of the road and everything, and how the road was left. And I'm also concerned with the lack of notice that was
given to the residents. So, Doug, I'll let you take it over from here because we have a couple different options. You want to take? You can take the meeting over from here. And
thank you. I was there today as well, and so I checked the surface, and we see the same thing that you do. There's still loose stone. There's still some tar coming off, and I don't know how long that would be, but with children, it's not a place you want them to play under any circumstances. I get that. Anyway, Mr. Bush, if you could spend a couple minutes talking about the options that you put together. I know there was an initial estimate that was considerably higher than the two options we see now.
Do you have a copy of these?
Yes.
Okay.
Good evening again. Yes, the original estimate, as the committee is aware, to do the to reconstruct the street to our city standards was just over $2 million. The committee had asked us to look at some other options, which I presented to the committee. The one option, from my memo, was to do some profile milling against the edges to accommodate a new inch and a half of asphalt and resurface everything with an inch and a half of asphalt. Option two would be to keep the existing chip seal that's there and then I'll move over here to the document camera, perform a fog seal method process which would ultimately look like this, or this is, I've given the committee a couple of pictures of different streets. These aren't obviously in Solon, but just examples of a tarn chip street that's been fog sealed. Ultimately, what this fog seal process is an asphalt emulsion that's sprayed over the top of the tarn chip surface. What it does is it encapsulates all the stone as the stone is worn into the to the tarn chip process or the tarn chip seal there from the traffic.
Do they roll it with a machine?
It's not at this process. This is just a spray application process. There's no rolling.
Okay.
Obviously, I think the contractor would come through and probably do some sweeping again just to make sure all the loose stone is again swept off before they would do something like do a fog seal process like that. But I know for sure that there's no post rolling.
Well, the issue question I have with this procedure is this street has, they're on Somme Center, these residents are on Somme Center and other residents. It's about four or five hot homes down there. So you're gonna get about 10 cars per day probably down the street, plus a mail truck or maybe a UPS truck or FedEx vehicle or something like that.
No, a mail truck doesn't go. They have to pick up their mail at the end of the street.
Okay, so maybe a UPS truck once a week or something like that, and a garbage truck once a week. So there's not really a lot of traffic to
sure.
compact this down. So if you spray it, even if you
right.
use the street sweeper, then you spray it to get it to compact, you're going to need a lot of traffic probably. And that's why I was asking if they're going to roll it or whatever, because otherwise we might be spending money to do this, spray this on there, and then we're not going to have enough traffic to compact it.
Well, the fog seal process itself doesn't need any rolling. The rolling is part of the chip and seal process that's already done. And then I understand your comments about the traffic. Obviously, Russell Drive does not, as we all know, doesn't have a lot of residents. So there's a lot less traffic than there would typically be on a typical residential street. But I have been out to the street a few times since the process has been done, as well as you have, and I do see that the chip and seal process is doing what it should be doing, kneading into itself. Obviously, with the traffic where it is, it could take a little longer than typical. I did stop. I didn't go out today, obviously, but I went a few times between the June and July meetings of the Public Works Committee just to check it out. The last time I was there, I stopped a few spots, walked around, kind of kicked at the stone just to see how it was, how loose it was. And I did, you know, I did was able to kick some stones loose, but, you know, I wasn't kicking the whole depth of the stone away, obviously. But it's, but it is kneading in like we would expect it to do. This is more kind of, it does, like I said, encapsulates the surface with the emulsion. But probably mostly it's more of an aesthetic topical treatment.
Yeah, that's the feeling I get. I mean, from a practical standpoint, if we want a road that they can really use, I think we have to go to asphalt. Don't you feel that way?
I just am concerned with option two. I'm concerned that they're going to get more of the same.
Yeah.
They're going to have the same issue, and the problem that these residents are experiencing are probably the same issues that other residents are experiencing, that they're getting, especially if you have kids, they're getting the chip seal product brought into their home. And the other concern that a resident, and they're not here tonight, that they had where their kids were riding on bikes, and they were having some issues with that too in the street.
Yeah, and I that was one of the main reasons why we ended up doing this process, because the other resident across the street there on Somme Center had come to see me a couple times, because the front section towards Somme was just annihilated with potholes, and he had said he had some family members, young kids, hit a couple of those and did a couple of headers over the bike, or had a few issues with some bikes. So that was the main reason why we did this, was for safety. The only thing I would also just advise it to the committee is the last time I looked back through our records, the last time we did this, did work on Russell Drive was 2006, and it was the same process as what we just did here. It was a final chip and seal. I don't recall that we had the concerns over the chip and seal as we have this time, but ultimately this surface will become a hard, stable surface that people are able to ride on, be able to walk on. And I know that a lot of other communities use it, not saying that we make a habit of using it, but and I think it was discussed at one of the last committee meetings, you know, we did this under our maintenance contract, so as a maintenance contract, we were maintaining the existing surface that was there, being chip and the tar and chip and seal.
But I think the residents who are here tonight were
It wasn't
the maintenance in front of their home, because they had a different surface.
I believe that stretch there was done by ODOT when they put the put Somme Center in to tie into the existing, or to make the transition from the concrete at Somme Center to Russell Drive.
I did have a question. A couple questions about fog seal.
Yep.
As we've discussed, or you've discussed a little bit tonight, that the chip seal is kind of it's a process, and it takes time, it takes
energy, heat,
you have to have vehicles driving over it, mm-hmm. and it's a process to come to a final product, which is a solid pathway, roadway.
Mm-hmm.
So if we were to fog seal it, first question would be, if we were to fog seal it, does that impede this process?
Shouldn't.
It shouldn't. So we're able to put this material on it, and it's still going to make its way into the base? And
yes. Yeah.
Okay.
And it actually might help actually smooth it up a little bit. Like I said, it's an asphalt emulsion, so you're going to be spraying more emulsion over the almost like black paint, if you would, but it's got some AC, as they call it, asphalt content to it, that to fill in and kind of combine all of the voids.
Okay. The second question with respect to fog seal is, how does that generally hold up in the wintertime? Because the way I'm imagining it or visioning it from the photographs, and I think I've obviously seen it throughout my travels over the years, is it something that through the winter with salt and plowing, where that because it almost seems like it's creating like a possible like rubber or tar membrane. Does that kind of split and crack and break off?
The thickness of it, or the application rate of it, isn't that thick where it's going to create like a thin membrane coating, like a piece of plastic or something over the top of it. It's not that thick.
So plowing and
there wouldn't be, the fog seal wouldn't have any issues. There wouldn't be any issues with plowing from the fog seal process.
Did your street get plowed today?
That wouldn't change.
No, Russell Drive gets plowed in the wintertime.
Okay, just wanted to make
sure.
Do
they salt it also?
I think they probably salt some, most likely probably towards the SOM Center. As far as the rate of the salt application up and down that street, I would have to defer that question to Mr. Dursey.
The salt doesn't impact this type of surface,
no,
does it?
No.
I'm just... A couple concerns I have is whether or not this surface is going to be, if it's just mainly aesthetic, I don't really want to spend the money on something if it's just aesthetic. But the other issue I'd like to touch on after we decide what, if any, direction we're going to go on is the section of this residence, front yard or side yard, and all the other residents, if we could have someone come out and restore the property so that they don't have the tar on their actual property.
From the picture that she showed? Yeah,
yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
If we could have someone, because that should be restored to the condition it was before they came out and did the work.
Would the fog seal be as smooth a surface as if we did asphalt?
No.
Okay. The asphalt, though, would probably require maintenance sooner than the fog seal.
Yes.
And what would be your guess?
Again, like I had said, the fog seal is more of an aesthetic process. Over time, what's going to happen with that is the sun will just...
Break it down.
It'll fade out just like any asphalt street fades out. The sun just absorbs the black AC out of the pavement, and ultimately it just fades out. As you look at residential streets or asphalt streets that have been installed for several years, they tend to have more of a grayish look to them versus black. That's just something that's inherent to asphalt streets over time. But as far as maintenance is concerned, I don't think there would be as much maintenance with the current surface as we would have with the asphalt.
My guess is, your assumption is that since we didn't do this street in the last 10 years, that you could probably make it last for another 10. Is that?
That'd be a fair assumption, yes.
That's the correct assumption. So. But if we put asphalt in, then it would require maintenance sooner, but it would be a better surface.
Yeah. And in preparation for the existing surface that we have there now, we did lay down 2 inches already of asphalt.
So then I have some questions with respect to your other proposal, your other option with respect to placing down asphalt. So in this option, if I'm I just want to make sure I'm understanding it correctly. We're not actually removing what is currently there, with the exception of, and maybe you can describe in a little more detail what profile milling is.
Profile milling would be just to, for instance, where the street meets the concrete at SOM Center, we would put an inch and a half profile edge there. Where the driveways meet, we would do some profile edging against the edge to blend in so that they wouldn't have an inch and a half drop to their existing driveway, that kind of stuff.
Okay.
There are, a lot of the residents there have existing stone driveways, so we actually would probably just pave right through those and then blend them in with some new stone.
So, in essence, we're going to just be laying right on top of this particular surface that's
yes.
there. So there is, it sounds to me like that there is an opportunity for this roadway to last even longer than what it has previously, just based on the base that might be there as a result of the work that's been done. I would think less water would be able to get through, because through the chip and seal process, it's going to create quite a barrier with that tar-like substance, that glue-like substance, correct?
In that situation, it's we do a lot of that, what you're speaking of on a lot of our other residential streets where they're existing mm-hmm. asphalt, we put a tar and chip layer in between. Primarily, it's used to help, I wouldn't say eliminate, but postpone, if you would, the reflective cracking of the asphalt from underneath.
Okay.
No, my instincts are that we go with an asphalt option here to give them a smooth surface and on top of the current chip and seal layer. I think that would work well. And I think you'd be happy with that.
Yes. Mark, what's your opinion?
My thoughts are that the fog sealing isn't going to work, and we're going to have to come back eventually anyways. And I guess that's kind of what my gut's telling me.
Mark, you put it very well. I was going to talk about more being an aesthetic version of, and it might look good for a matter of a couple months, and then it'll fade, and it'll be back to where you are now, and we'll throw $5,000 of taxpayer money just away.
And I feel like the work that's been done isn't like it's been wasted. I feel like we're going to be giving ourselves more of a more solid base than what was originally there before we did the chip and seal.
Okay, so is there a motion from the committee?
I just have one more question. My thought is that there are a number of streets in Solon whereby we have these kinds of issues. This is the first that I think has come to the attention of this committee here. But do we have a strategic plan to upgrade some of these streets, or are we leaving that to potential developers doing something? It's not a city plan to upgrade streets.
And I'm not the planning director.
So I'm asking the wrong guy. Beat you up regardless?
But I can play the planning director like I'm on TV. But I would say that there are some streets that are similar to Russell. There's some that are in better condition, or different applications have asphalt similar to what the residents showed, like Arlington. There's one that comes to mind that's worse, Willow Street, which is just stone only.
Yeah, I know where that
doesn't
is.
Have chip seal on it or nothing. So as far as Russell's concerned, it's not the worst one as far as I guess relative to being compared to asphalt as the creme de la creme, if you would. But streets such as like Willow, I would just use as an example, are based on the policies that have been put in place through the zoning code, I think are, I guess, deemed to be developer driven because the code requires them to be developed up to our current city standards, much like this estimate that I had provided to the committee when these discussions first
So the answer is no, we don't have a strategic plan, and yes, we're expecting developers to take that when that happens.
Yes.
Okay. All right. Very good. I'd like to propose that our engineering department prepare an estimate to resurface the existing chip and seal with 1.5 inches of asphalt with profile milling on the road edge.
So this isn't an estimate?
This is an estimate. If the committee would want to move forward, obviously, as you know, I just put the asphalt annual out for bid. If the committee would like to add, and it's not in the budget that I just presented with, I had discussion with the committee tonight, obviously.
You've got 3 days.
We do have the ability to add, we could add, where I was going with this is we could add this to that estimate and add it as another area of work as an addendum to the contract that's currently out for bid.
So then you don't really need legislation?
No.
No, if the committee wants to direct us to add this area of work as an addendum to the 2017 asphalt annual, we could certainly do that.
Okay, that's fine. So you don't need anything other than a consensus?
That is the request of the committee, it seems like.
Okay, so we don't need a motion or anything else then? Okay.
All right, very good.
The other point that I'd just like, is there anything, John, that you can, we can do? Is there any holdback money on this, the prior work that was done, so we can get the, just that small little piece of their property and other properties.
There may be others.
Fixed, yeah, if you can get someone out there just to take a look down the street to see whether other properties have been affected too. I know it's only a small little portion.
Yeah, I'm sure Dan will probably have the inspectors take a look at that tomorrow.
Great.
Anything probably similar to those pictures that were shown will be something that we could just easily just pick up and put in our truck.
That would be great, thank you. Thanks for being here tonight, John.
Thank you, John. Thank you, Dan.
Thanks, Dan.
Okay, is there anything further from the committee?
No, we're good.
Entertain a motion.
A motion we adjourn.
Second.
Proceed to vote.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mr. McGill?
Yes.
Mr. Palumbo?
Yes.